not the church, not the state. Women must decide our fate. Not the church, not the state. Women must decide our fate.
They say
no choice.
We say
pro-choice.
They say
no choice.
We say
pro-choice.
They say
no. Silence a passion that runs through my veins from the roots of my mother and her grandmother. Here I stand to fight for abortion rights, to fight using my voice, and we are so close to that bigger picture, to a state that decriminalizes a form of healthcare. And there is a quote, one that I hold closer than most. It reads, "Scream so that one day, 100 years from now, another sister will not have to dry her tears wondering where in history she lost her voice." Silence is an act of violence in itself. Silence does not cause change or reign. It only ensures stillness and pain. Reproductive rights ensure bodily autonomy, and bodily autonomy dictates identity. And without my identity, without my voice, I am just, what am I? I fight because I am not free. Until I have control over my own body. I am not free until I can assert my own bodily integrity. I am not free until my sisters are. I am not free until all pregnant people are. I am not free until I can call my body my own. I am not free, I am not free, we are not free. Until this legislation is reformed. When it comes to reproductive rights, the choice should be left to a pregnant person. And I cannot emphasize this enough. Abortion is a personal choice, not a political debate. Politicians have no place in your doctor's office, but it seems that we now have to convince men that we deserve rights. We now have to prove the reasons for our rights, as if healthcare is not a fundamental right, as if it is a privilege. Abortion access saves lives. The beauty of the pro-choice movement is that you do not have to morally agree with abortion to consider yourself as pro-choice. That's why it's not called pro-abortion. It's an understanding that you can't make the choice for someone, and acknowledging that they have full control over their body and not you. It is the political and ethical view that a pregnant person should not have to control their fertility and should have complete control over their fertility and the choice to continue or terminate a pregnancy.
Our bodies, our choice. Our bodies, our choice.